Summer Games Done Quick 2014 is brought to you in part by Avermedia, The Humble Bundle, SomethingArtistic.net, The Yeti, and Mad Cats. If you're looking forward to the next block, one thing I would encourage you to do is to subscribe to the stream. It's a simple way to support the cause. 100% of your subscription money will go towards the charity Doctors Without Borders. And be sure to use the hashtag SGDQ2014 when talking about Summer Games Done Quick on Twitter. Coming up next, Spike Vegeta takes the mic. And Bass Boost shows us Goldeneye. We do have a couple donations to read here in between games while they're setting up. We have a donation from Tyler Powell, $20. The sounds of seasons woke me up, so that was lucky. Thank you for the donation. By the way, thanks to everybody who donated at least $20 during that block to potentially win the Ages and Seasons bundle. Lots of people doing that at the last minute there. $10 from Yao44. Thanks for this awesome marathon, which is showing to the world that video games can be a good thing. Kisses from France. Well, if there's one thing I like, it's a French kiss. So thank you for the donation, Yao44. $10 from HeyBay5000. Having a lot of fun watching. Keep it up and good luck. Thank you for the donation. $100 from Shala. The jumps you're making in Oracle of Seasons are incredible. Thank you for the donation. We've got $5 from Katie Bracey. Don't have much to donate, but every bit counts. I will donate another $5 if two people watching start dancing. So anybody on the webcam right now. Looks like you guys on your phones. How convenient. Get up and dance. Let's see some moves.
Yeah, Groovy Bar.
Summer Games Done Quick 2014. It's time to dance. Get up. Come on, act excited over there. Look at this boring crowd over here. You get like 4 hours of sleep combined over there. Let's make some noise. Get up. Right now. I'm serious. Get up. Stand up. Let's make some moves. All right. This one guy here, that was the most athletic thing we've had this entire break. He stood up. There we go. All right. That's all we're going to get. Well, I tried. We've got an anonymous $50 donation. Thank you for that. $20 from David Hatta. I love the Legend of Zelda games. Awesome seeing it done so quickly. Keep up the good work, everyone. We've got $35 from Musical Friend. First time watching SGDQ Live and loving it. Thanks to all the runners and happy to put my money towards a good cause. $20 from Who Is Code. First time watching a live speedrun. Love me some Zelda. Thanks for the donation. An anonymous $50 donation. Thanks again. We have a $5 donation from Trifang. My friend Tim White has leukemia, and this is for him. Good job, Nanas, and I'm glad this will be money for a good cause. Thanks, guys. And just an update on some of the bid incentives, donation incentives that will be occurring here. You guys did meet the requirement for the 100% run of GoldenEye, so that will happen. You also raised enough money for Watch Me Die difficulty in Doom 64, which is the hardest difficulty mode. So you will be seeing a very difficult run from Peaches in Doom 64. There are still plenty of things that need money as far as challenges or different donation incentives. So if you're looking to put your money towards something, it looks like some things that have not been met yet. The Dragon Coins and Moons run of Super Mario World still needs a little less than $1,000 to happen tomorrow. Looks like there are several file names still available. So when you donate, just be sure to click on something there and put your money towards it.
All right. Can you hear me on stream? Yeah, I can hear myself through the speakers now. Okay.
Can you hear me?
Speak a little louder.
Speaking louder.
There. Yeah, you're fine.
All right.
All right. Whenever we're ready, I'm good to go. You can do a countdown. That'd be great.
Okay, so Goldeneye N64, it's a classic game. Also a classic meme right here. You see him strafe running and looking down. Looking down is to reduce lag, and it also has the nice effect of reducing Bond's hitbox a little bit, because they actually have the head look down, which reduces his profile. And strafe running is, of course, faster than going in a straight line. So he's going to be doing that throughout this whole thing, changing directions only as necessary, and trying to keep his finger on a strafe button as often as possible. You also probably noticed that this is on the Japanese version of the game. It's not for the reasons you would expect, because the Japanese text actually lags this game a little bit, so it's actually a little bit slower. Not a lot, though.
That's
big thing.
Minimal, but it does affect ILs enough to warrant using different systems.
The big things for using the Japanese version are, first off, body armor. Every single body armor in this game is present on every single difficulty. That is not always the case on the North American version. And it's very beneficial, especially in a few levels like the Depot, for example, where there's a body armor that he can get to quickly, which allows him to use more aggressive strats in a marathon setting.
Whoa.
Okay, that was a little risky here. He still has a reasonable amount of health. He's going to shoot a box up here in a second to try to use invincibility frames from the negligible damage from the box. There it is. That just reduces his chances of getting a headshot from the guards or something like that. But the other reason that the Japanese version is used is because of a little quirk in the auto-aim system. Basically, the way it works is that the way this game treats the auto-aim is like Secret Agent in the North American version, where the auto-aim for North American 00 is ever so slightly different. And using the one present in the Japanese version, which is like the Secret Agent, actually makes it significantly easier to get headshots. So that's another nice benefit for using the Japanese version. Now in facility, the big thing here is Dr. Doak. Where is he?
Not there. Not there.
Not there.
If I get 5 chances to get to him, if not, it's a restart. Kind of just pure RNG.
And another thing you've probably seen him do is shooting so that guards open doors for him, which obviously is faster.
Oh, that's best dope.
Also alerting them.
Nice.
And you only have to meet Doak. You don't have to have the whole conversation, so that's why he ran away immediately there. Objective complete. And of course, you don't need all five mines, so use them earlier in the level. You just position them right and you can get away with three. Now he has to wait for Trevelyan to leave. Otherwise, things can go wrong, and then...
Hope that completed. I got boosted out the ending.
Yeah, that worked.
Scary.
And in 00 Agent, it's actually better to get the tank here because of the tank's cannon, primarily. And on 00 Agent, you have to take out three turrets and a SAM. And it's much easier with the tank.
Yeah, you can only blow them up with explosives, so unless you're really lucky, the grenades are the only other option.
Or if you're TASBOT, that works too.
Yeah. Play a little safe here. Wasn't sure. That first drone's kind of tricky to hit, so if you go in the plane too early, you'll fail. You don't have the all the drones completed in time. They can complete after you get in the plane, though. But.
And this level is going to be a lot of running around, so it's a pretty good time for donations.
Yeah.
Just one quick thing to say, that the hitbox reduction is particularly nice in this level.
Yeah. If I'm not looking down at the ground at like around 70 degrees, guards will hit me more and I could die, so. And mandatory.
And with that, go ahead and read a few donations.
Sure. I've got a $20 donation from Kyle H3. I love what everyone there is doing. Great cause. Shoutouts to the crew that made this all possible. Thank you very much, Kyle. I've got a $5 donation from Katie Bracey. As promised, here's another $5 for the quote-unquote dancing. Thanks for the effort, announcer. And I've got another donation here from Trevelyan. Good luck looking at the floor, James. It shouldn't take more than a minute. Just remember that half of everything is luck, and the other half, fate. And that donation was for $1,000.
Nice. Yeah, if we had a slightly different setup, I was tempted, because my name is Alec, to do something in the cradle level. Instead, I'll probably just do a little pantomime then. We'll see. But anyway, continue.
Yes, of course. I've got a $20 donation from Sergeant Raven. Greetings, Spike, Bass Boost, and everyone else. Sergeant Raven here. It was great meeting most of you at AGDQ 2014, and I wish I could have made it to SGDQ. I've enjoyed watching as many runs as possible. Shoutouts to Alex, Goose, Boss, Clemens, and everyone else with the Elite. Good luck on your run, and I hope the Aztec glass strat is good to you. Alex, if you and the rest of the crowd shout, Jimbo sucks, I'll donate another $20. See you all in 2015. Thanks. Thank you very much, Sergeant Raven.
Jimbo sucks.
Jimbo sucks!
That is true. That is very true.
No, we love you, Jim. Okay. Maybe they're scary.
This level is generally fairly consistent, but that's never a guarantee.
Nothing's a guarantee in this game, ever. Meat shield, please.
Yeah, another thing that can happen, in addition to guards that are in the process of dying, standing in front of other guards, is shooting the weapon, which deals very negligible damage. And that can cause issues in a few levels. Throwing grenades as well. One of the guards earlier pulled a grenade, which could have been a problem.
I got it too.
And there was an explosion. I've also seen Boris walk around the long way through the start of the level, which was a thing.
These guards are jerks. I got through already.
Yeah. Sometimes they can block you.
All right, this next level coming up is a real challenge.
Yeah, this one is very, very heavy on NPC luck. You need guards and scientists to cooperate. Scientists have dats and need to stay out of your way and not die. And guards need to stay out of your way and not kill you. Both of which can very much be a problem, especially in this next room like this.
Yeah, but also the guards can walk through doors without opening them, and I can get locked out of certain areas, so.
Scientists humorously can be some of the dumbest NPCs in the game.
Yeah, that comes up again later.
Oh my gosh.
Wow.
Wow, let's not go in there.
Yeah, do not throw plastique into that explosion. Fortunately,
that doesn't matter.
The plastiques getting hit and exploding is generally not a problem in this level.
Get out of my way.
But yeah, you saw right there, the guards can easily get in the way or cooperate.
Or just not go indoors there.
And then troll again.
Wow.
Now he needs that scientist.
Please drop your dat.
Yeah, that's this level.
I'll make this door cycle. No, I'm not gonna make it. No, I have to go back to the key now. No, don't blow up the plastic. Scary. You pulled an 8. That's scary. Get out of here. We're good now. They can blow up those consoles and then you're starting to die. In there, dude.
And so long, Orimov.
I lost a bit of time there. I had to go back to the key card and the guards were kind of trolly, but at least they lived.
It beats dying or having too many scientists die. In this level, the main thing is hostages. He's actually using a slightly slower route than you would in an individual level, simply because of the hostages needing to escape.
Where are you going?
He's going somewhere. He's on a mission.
It's sort of random how long it takes the hostages to escape, so you can get kind of stuck at the end of the level. Based on bad luck,
it's a common theme. Near the end of the level, he's going to be looking for objective A to complete, and that
Jesus.
Is the.
Where's he going? Like, what are these guards doing?
The guards in this game are something special, both for better and worse. Often worse, but sometimes they're just hilarious. And right here, he's going to clip through. Right there.
Oh, nice. I can't believe that worked.
That is one of the few beneficial clips in this game.
Uh-oh. Get out of here, dude. Oh, get out of my way.
The roll.
I almost died. This is a really weird frigate. I've never seen half this stuff ever happen before.
The frigate that never happened before. But yeah, you can obviously throw the tracker bug from a much greater distance, but this being a marathon run, he's playing it safe.
Yeah. So we gotta hope for objective A now to save some time. It's random though, but we did the best strat to maximize our odds. Hostages, please. Jerks. Come on.
There it is.
There you go.
See, it's not at all uncommon to have to wait before entering the boat for that objective to complete.
All right, it's another good level for donations. It's a lot of just strafing around and very minimal risk, so. Wanna go ahead, Spike?
Sure. And if you guys wanna real quick give us a roll call on the couch and the runner. Right.
I'm Alec K47.
I'm Overfiend.
Zost.
And I'm Bassboost or Alex W. Anderson on Twitch.
All right. Got a couple donations here. I got $20 from Draken. First time hearing of this event. Love seeing the skill needed to do these runs so fast. Great cause, great games, and great players. Keep it up. Thank you very much, Draken. I've also got a $5 donation from Alan's Mark. First time ever donating. Had to donate for Goldeneye. Good luck, mate. Thank you, mate.
Thank you.
I've also got a $35 donation from Chaos Link. Hello, this is my first donation towards the GDQ, and I am happy I can finally contribute to the cause. Loved Bananas Oracle of Seasons Run. I'm putting my whole donation value on the Blame TR file name for Skyward Sword. Hope the marathon continues to thrive as it has so far. Thank you all very much for your donations. Already raised close to $215,000. That's not even including what we've raised from the Humble Bundle, which make sure to check that out if you go further down the Games Done Quick page. And if you like first-person shooters, this is only the first of a block of three classics. After this, it's Doom 64, run on Watch Me Die difficulty by Peaches. Make sure to check out that run. And then you're going to have Halo on Legendary, run by Goat Rope.
Used a bit of a safety strat there to prevent what happened in a previous marathon run.
Yeah.
Basically, he made sure to shoot each of the little pieces of the radio at least a little bit so that they took more damage and would be guaranteed to explode when they hit the ground. Now, I'm going to say a little bit about the next level here because it's going to be serious time for him.
Yes, basically, one of the hardest levels in the game.
He needs to be very precise, especially on his camera shots, or else all sorts of guard cycles and things can get way out of whack and it can become interesting. We'll just say that. And with that, I'm going to shut up.
Play a little safe at the end here.
All right, that was really good.
That was really,
really
good.
Solid. Let's give this guy a hand. Statue, there isn't too much to the first part of the level. It's just running through it and getting to Valentin Zhukovsky as fast as you possibly can, and then blurring him out a little bit so that you're closer to where you need to be to meet Trevelyan or Giannis. And until the end of the level, like I said, there just isn't very much. So, except for right after Trevelyan, there are some things that can go wrong. If one of the guards pulls a grenade and kills himself or another one of the personal guard, then issues happen at the end of the level. They can spawn back where he started, and that makes things a bit less fun. Because, yeah, this game obviously is not glitchy at all.
All right, so we just strafe against or just run against the statue to maintain full speed. There's an acceleration in this game. It takes about a half second to hit full speed. You always want to be trying to get that full speed everywhere you go.
That's helps there for like a time buffer, yeah. So he knows exactly when to start moving.
Yeah, you'll see that one or two more times. He's going to do it again in this level just for luck, because it's a superstition thing.
Yeah, we have a tradition here to affect the FR at the end of the level.
Yeah, because you need the helicopter's recorder box thingy.
Yeah, the flight recorder. It can spawn in 9 different locations. 3 of them are good. In a marathon, 6 are bad.
He would say sorry, Natalia, but that would be a lie.
It's true. All right, so let's try to affect the FR. Oh, all right. Nice. That was one of the optimal ones. Saves us up to 7 seconds.
So the guards didn't spawn there, and he was able to get Natalia to die without really dying and failing the level.
You can only do that if you get the good FRs.
Now this level is very technical movement, so pay attention. If done right, it looks really smooth.
A bad door open there.
Getting through all this stuff smoothly is probably...
And the knack probably... sometimes not see you there, so...
Yeah, you do actually have to get into the room a bit there.
There we go. Oh my.
And guards can definitely troll in this section.
Oh my. Okay, we really got screwed over there.
Yeah. That's unfortunate,
that's
but
unfortunate.
It
did,
just
like,
happens
sometimes.
I did,
like, a strat where that, like, works 99% of the time, but got bad luck.
Yeah.
Cards are in weird places. Grenade, hopefully Nat doesn't die. Wow. Quite really safe and just stay here. So streets is a kind of dangerous level sometimes. You get rockets or grenade launcher guards, they can just one kill you. They kind of random if they spawn or not. So it's interesting.
That shooting Valentin there was basically for positioning and movement.
He'll freeze in place if you shoot him, otherwise he'll, like, if you get shot, he might rock in front of you and die. There should be more guards coming, so I'm gonna have to... Or there. Right, though. Well, there could be a grenade launcher guard here. I have to check for him, because he will one-shot you. The one other spot where a grenade launcher guard can spawn. That one's the most dangerous one. Okay, I don't have to dodge rockets at the first set. That's really nice.
You can probably read a donation because this level has pretty much been explained.
Yeah, I've got a $100 donation from Aaron Hill. First time catching GDQ live. Had to donate during the awesome Goldeneye run. Great runs, great cause. Keep it up.
This point is actually safer than you would think with all the rocket launchers.
But we all know what happened last year at AGR 2013. So
if you get a really...
I got sideshot into a rocket. Like, I don't think that was dodgeable. All right, glad that didn't happen this time.
Now, like I said earlier, there's a body armor in this level that is normally not there on the North American version.
I just learned about this body armor a few months ago. There's like 15 of them in this level. That one saves about 8 seconds of what I was doing before, so that's really cool.
And it definitely helps because there are a couple rooms in here that he has to do that can do quite a bit of damage. Especially with the ZMGs less than perfect accuracy.
Oh jeez, the key is going. The key damage. Wow. Bugs in this game are special. I'll try to get out of here before that door closes and saves like another 3 seconds on top of being faster. That key was just not cooperating. Jeez. Not normally what happens there.
Those last couple boxes just don't like to explode.
You can't shoot a second rocket there because there's so much lag, it just goes right through the floor.
Yeah, that's actually a common problem at that particular
point.
There's
a trick called the train shot I could have done there, but my health's really low, so I don't want to risk dying. But yeah. I will see it again on the cheat section.
The train shot is just shooting at the train to alert the guards in that area and hopefully get this door and the train door opened for you. But it's a little bit riskier simply because that's more guards that can shoot you.
All right, so this is where the run really gets challenging. Next block of like 6 levels are all really hard. Chance of death on every one of them is pretty high. I got a bad spawn there.
Yeah, there's randomness in both the spawns and behavior of the guards here, so he has to play it safe. They can also troll by ducking a lot.
Yeah, when they duck, it just wastes like 3 seconds per duck. I don't know what those guys are doing. Let's hope for the best.
This is a bit of a gauntlet. You want to get through here while taking as little damage as possible, ideally. It's not...
a lot more dangerous than it looks.
Yeah, it's... you can take a fair amount of damage through there. That was actually really clean.
Jeez,
and then
that
these
guy.
That's why you want to get to that point with relatively good health, because those guys can deal quite a lot of damage.
I did a trick there where if you get out fast enough before Natalia gets saved, she won't know you left the train, so you can save time at the end here. You'll still do her objectives.
And that was the reason because, the reason he took the time to actually...
Yeah, if you're really good, you can get out there before the, without doing any locks beforehand, but it's just such a high risk that I just wanted to play it safe. It's really a hard trick to do.
Yeah, but as
like you can read donations for 30 seconds,
yeah,
just waiting for the timer to count down here.
Yeah, sure. I've got a $100 donation from DNTN31. Good luck on the run, Alex. Boost it.
Thanks, Mark.
I've got another $20 from Sergeant Raven. Sergeant Raven again. Here's the other $20 as promised. It's fun donating to a great cause on behalf of Picking on Jimbo. Alex, I look forward to seeing you at the next Minnesota meet. Good luck again on your run.
Thank you.
And I have got a $25 donation from Joshua Nash. Hey, Alex, good luck with the run. I always enjoyed watching you stream at night to trance music. I swear the music makes you PB.
Thanks. All right, so this is another pretty tough level here. The guards control you pretty bad here. It's just all RNG, but hopefully I get a decent patterns. Uh-oh. We got problems. All right, yeah, that's a start.
Yeah, taking that much damage that fast is...
yeah. There's literally almost no chance at that point.
Yeah.
Alright, hopefully we can kill that guard this time. There we go. I missed that guy's. Oh my god, both their ammo just in dumb spots. Where is it? I can't see it. The tea's way too dark. What the heck? Where did it go? Wow. Unfortunate. Alright, so we're gonna try not to spawn Zinnia early to take her out consistently. Should be good enough, hopefully. Nice.
That's how the Zinnia fight is supposed to go. It doesn't always work out that way, but that's what it's supposed to look like.
It's really scary.
You technically couldn't see him there, right?
Yeah, there.
Couldn't see you. The tree root was blocking her vision somehow.
A few other levels like that, where you can shoot through, but they're like walls for the enemy, they can't see through them. Oh my god, there's a grenade.
Yeah, grenades are generally very bad news at that point in the level. They can...
There's been a lot of grenades this round.
They can just completely end it. But he had a lot of health there, and the grenade didn't hit him directly. Now, this level is probably notorious for its difficulty. And it's still pretty challenging. The big thing in this level, in addition to... the beginning section and the area where you have to protect Natalia is coming up fairly shortly. Yeah. There's a section where it's going to depend greatly on how much damage he takes. There's a very real possibility that he will just get wrecked in this area coming up here after this.
Yeah, it's the scariest part of the level for sure. For the best. Oh god, that guy's ducking in my way. Grenade, Jesus. Scary stuff. God, charging guards are bad too. Okay, it's scary, but we might be okay.
Yeah, it is entirely possible to die there, especially if, like you saw there, you get trolled by a guard getting in your way, or if they throw a grenade, all sorts of things can happen there.
Oh, guy's coming around.
He's shooting that out to reduce lag.
Yeah, sorry, Australia. Oh, I got a guard behind me. This is really bad. Drone, please. We're just gonna kill that guy. Scary. I'm gonna have to get that drone after.
Oh, no. Yeah, he wants to clear that area out a bit before.
Whatever, that's good.
Natalia. Yeah.
So I need to run there
to
at the end
console.
Of the level, and I don't have time to take it out then. So. There's a guard there. This is a little more nerve-wracking than normal because I have really bad health right now. But we should be okay. Okay, where are you going? Come on. That was unfortunate.
Also, destroying that console to the right allows Natalia to take a more direct path when she leaves. I think it saves about a fraction of a second.
Gotta save them frames.
Thank you. Well, the guards with black hats are targeting me, and the guards without the black hats are going after Natalia. So you can kind of plan, based on her health and Natalia's health, what to prioritize. Right now I'm prioritizing all the black guards, because he has full health right now and I don't. The nade. I hope that didn't go off. That'll kill her if it does. Oh, cool. Whoa. What the heck, man? Oh no. I might die. That's like 5 minute time loss. Oh shoot, I got a grenade. Alright. Inventory got screwed up. I don't even know what I can do. I might be just screwed here. Oh no. Door, please. Open. No, don't do it. Don't do it. Don't do it.
Oh.
I gotta go back and do the, not over yet.
Needless to say, you do not normally go into that area. You just had so little health that...
Activate completed, I hope. I really gotta look. Oh, we can't look. I'm pause glitched and I got boosted into the elevator. You can't move when you're pause glitched. That was scary, man.
You can all breathe for a second. Yeah.
There's a very precise shot here, and he needs scientists to cooperate as well.
Oh, I got
well.
Shot. I didn't get my bullet out. That happens sometimes.
Yeah, so that scientist is doomed, which means he's going to have to play it safe a little bit later in the level, but he has to go fast here and get ahead of Trevelyan.
I really hope A completes. Please. We gotta restart.
And he has to restart because sometimes those consoles don't
get
destroyed.
Yeah, I had to throw the mine really, really fast to beat Trev out of there, as otherwise it would have been locked out. But fortunately, I misplaced the mine by probably a couple pixels. We have a chance at it, though. Got the bad lure.
Now, at that point, the scientist can either run away or run back towards the console. It's actually a little bit inconsistent.
Since I have to go the slow route, because I got a bad scientist lure, I'm going to throw an extra mine just to take that A out for sure. You actually need all your mines if you use the other strategy, but it's like a super high-risk strategy. If I die, I'll lose 3 minutes, so.
The two routes that he could have taken are going to diverge in just a second here. He could either head directly through the corridor that takes you past the one to the end directly to the radio, but that is quite risky, so he's going to take it safe and go around here, kill some guards, make sure that they don't get in his way later, and approach the radio from a slightly less risky direction.
I can also save both the scientists by doing this. Otherwise, they're going to die for sure.
Correct, and that's one of the big things, especially like with the scientists early in the level. If you don't manage to save all of them, then it's worth taking a little bit of extra effort to save the scientists by the radio.
Those mines earlier...
Fortunately, I can't see anything on this TV, so I'm going to have to invest.
Those mines earlier were also the destroyed guards.
I won't die. Oh my god. Really frustrating. Oh my god, it killed the scientist. Luckily, I didn't fail.
Well, it didn't fail.
Okay, well.
But that means that scientist in there really has to survive.
To go. If he dies, run over. Just some barrels blowing up, that always happens. Okay.
At this point, you don't strictly have to destroy those, but it's just much safer. You have to wait for Trevelyan anyway, so it doesn't really cost any time.
Alright, cool. One of the scariest levels in the run. Alright, so we're gonna use a trick on this level to abuse Trevelyan's AI into making him commit suicide. Unfortunately, the trick is a little inconsistent, and sometimes it takes upwards of 30 seconds, and sometimes it takes 3 seconds. He's one gun. Those guards can spawn with one or two guns. Ideally, you want two.
So Trevelyan goes in there. Now he's just going to kind of back up against this wall.
Hey, throw the grenade, great. Not a bad one.
And boom.
He didn't kill himself, there he goes.
And there it is, objective B completed.
Sure, he doesn't quite die.
Sometimes he also destroys the console, but that's rare.
Yeah, well, that one's rare. And I had one gun there, so I had a little harder time killing that console. Two guns, it'll go down twice as fast. Right, so this is the end of the regular game. There's two bonus missions you unlock by beating the game on the hardest difficulties. So we'll play through those as well, and then it'll be the cheat section.
In this level, the big thing is glass luck. It was mentioned earlier in a donation. And basically what that is a manipulation to get guards to open an area that is normally not the easiest to access in the level. Get there earlier, basically. And it saves quite a bit
of
time.
Like 90 seconds.
So I'll talk about that a little bit more when he gets
there. There's invisible walls here on this bridge, so they can't shoot me if I'm on that bridge. I like to abuse that as much as possible. They gave me a bad pattern. But yeah, it's super safe. These guards do a lot of damage. Health's not great. We're gonna lure four guards over here.
So basically, what he's doing here is he's luring the guards and then buffering so that this.
Brad, if they're running like that, you have almost no chance.
He
needs. Kind of animation dependent.
He needs that doorway thing to close, and then he needs to make noise by the glass so that the guards go up there. In this case, he had a guard stuck there, and so that reduces the chance of getting the guards to open.
I think I have a second guard stuck in there too. No.
But it looks like they're cooperating.
No, they're not gonna
Maybe.
Open it. No, they're
no. They're just standing there. But anyway, had it worked, one of the guards would have opened that and allowed him to upload the flight data that much faster.
You can't really see him. You can shoot that thing, so kind of annoying.
And if he had a grenade here, he would have just tossed it to the end of this part of the corridor.
Oh, what? Please.
And it would have blown up both of those turrets.
Was he playing a grenade? Maybe, I'm not sure if he was, but he looked like it. Can't see it on this TV, unfortunately. I'm thinking of a drone right now. There we go.
So this is a safe strat. He's killing those guards because he's low on health. And he could just run right over there and hit the console.
Coming out of there? I don't know where he was.
Daddy got blast luck.
I'm luring Jaws over here early as possible.
Now, Jaws is generally pretty safe because he shoots past you if you're right up point blank with
him. The guards behind him can pull grenades. There we go.
Yeah, a guard throwing a grenade is actually the biggest risk in that fight.
Yeah, because of how Jaws extends his arms, if you're right next to him, right up close like that, he can't really hit you.
All right, so there's respawn guards at the end, and they all have lasers, so let's hope they spawn here. It's a lot safer than in the vents on the way back. That's it. They don't have to worry about guards for the rest of the level now. If they spawn in here, they can really do damage to you.
But now he can go to the console, launch the rocket, and finish the level.
All right, if you want to read donations, the last 30-second countdown here. Go right ahead.
I've got a $20 donation from Yoshiels. This is just too awesome. I get to relax after work on my birthday to watch my favorite game get destroyed. If you all could wish me a happy birthday today, it would make my day. Thank you, everyone, and have a wonderful day.
Happy birthday.
Happy birthday.
Happy birthday. And the 54,000 in chat.
Alright, so this is the last level in the game, but it is actually one of the easier levels. They just put a maze in the Golden Gun room, which is really cryptic if you don't know it, but once you learn it, it's possibly the easiest level, the last 10.
And yeah, as you saw, he basically grabbed the ammo the instant he started opening. The big thing here is killing Samity fast. That was not ideal,
yeah,
but
it's kind of a tricky shot. You can't really see him. You have to time the shot. There, he's gone.
There, that was a headshot, so that's fast. And right there, he got a glitch. It's based off of lag. You have to switch your weapons in a certain way while the game is lagging, and you can get two different weapons like that at the same time. It is most definitely a glitch. And Samity took a little while longer than normal there.
Right. So that's the hardest part of the game. I'm kind of glad that went not too bad.
And now he's actually not going all the way back to the dam to start to unlock the cheats, because at the end of the dam, this is a damage boost here. At the end of the dam, there's that cutscene where Bond jumps, and so he wants that to be not part of the time. Just a minor optimization that saves a couple seconds.
Yeah, if you have any donations to catch up on, now's a great time.
Sure, let's see what we got here. I've got a $20 donation from Jonathan Moritz. Donating again. While money's been tight lately, it's for a good cause, and therefore very worth it. No, Mr. Bond, I expect you to go fast. I've got a $50 donation from Nativity in Black. Had some extra money coming in, so now I'm able to donate, and Floor Watcher 64 seems like the perfect time. Put this towards Metal Wolf Chaos so President Wilson can pilot a giant mech and save America, just in time for the 4th of July. I like your thinking.
That is a very American choice for your donation. I approve.
I've got a $20 donation from Poetsy. We'll donate another $100 if you say, Twee La Corn is bad for children. Well, I said it. All right, there you go.
Twee La Corn is bad for children. Okay, I
was about to say, is that 200? All right, we can run this up a little bit. Also got a $100 donation from Balthasar228. Need I remind you, 007, that you have a license to kill, not to break the traffic laws. Awesome run of one of my favorite games of all time. We'll donate an additional 150 if the entire... we're getting requests. An additional 150 if the entire room can tell me the answer to the following. Okay, I didn't read this before. What does the scouter say about Spike's fro level? But runner's choice if he can tell me what real-life structure was the location of the cradle level.
I actually don't know that, but I'm getting... In the movie, it's Cuba. I don't know where the real-life one was shot.
It's actually in... I want to say... It's South America, I think, like, or Central. I used to know this. I want to say it's like Costa Rica or something, maybe. That's the one that's coming to mind. I could very well be wrong. But it's a big observatory there.
Artist level is one of the harder levels to do quick, so I'm gonna try to do this one best I can. Anyone likes watching Silo, you can follow Ryan Lockwood grinding out the
Silo
attempts.
Grinder.
Yeah.
How many hours does he have into that now? 100 hours?
Probably more than that.
I think we needed to say something about Spike's fro level. Three, two, one. It's over 9,000!
And there you go.
So like a lot of levels, this level isn't quite as bad the second time around, generally speaking, simply because you don't have to do as much. He doesn't have to rely nearly as much on the DAT, a scientist, because he doesn't have to get the DATs. He basically just has to get through, take the picture. And that makes this level a lot more bearable on the lower difficulties.
I know, pretty good.
Frigate is basically the same.
That's essentially, I use the same strat, even though you can take riskier strats. I just want to guarantee a hostage completion. We use the same strat. Usually more consistent. You have to have 4 of them escape on Secret Agent and 5 on Double O. There's 6 to them. We do save all 6. To Dwayne.
Yeah, Dwayne is a specific face that can show up on guards and scientists and such.
He's known as the ugly guard.
There are some ugly guards, but Dwayne takes it to a whole different level.
There we go, objective A early, so I don't have to wait this time.
Summer Games Done Quick is brought to you by The Yeti, SomethingArtistic.net, Mad Cats, and AverMedia.
And you can keep going with donations.
Yeah, you can keep
right?
going. This level is much more simple.
I think up till jungle is a really easy portion of the run.
Well, sure. I like the sound of my voice. Let's go. All right. I've got a $20 donation from Original Tai Chi.
From the door?
My first SGDQ. First run I follow from the start, and it's a beloved game I played again and again and again. And above all, it's for a good cause. Guys, how could I not be a part of it? Thanks a lot for the great proof to the world that shooting people on video games don't make you a killer, but the exact opposite. Good luck with all these Soviet bastards. Happy face.
All right. Thanks for the donation.
I've got a $20 donation from Cray Leon. The U.S. is through to the next round of the World Cup. How else can we celebrate them by making sure we get Metal Wolf Chaos?
Indeed.
All cutscenes on stream. How? Every single American today needs to open up their wallets and get this thing done.
For America, very much. I approve and agree.
Shoutouts to Canada?
even if you aren't from America, Metal Wolf Chaos is an awesome and hilarious game, and you definitely want to see it. Trust me on that.
I agree. You definitely want to donate for that.
And as cringeworthy as it might have been, I do have a $150 donation from Balthasar228. As promised, by the way, the cradle level is based on the Arecibo Radio Telescope in Puerto Rico.
Puerto Rico, yeah. I knew it was a radio telescope. And it's, I believe, part of a larger observatory facility as well. They're spellbinding, those feet.
Want to remind you guys once again that while you are enjoying Goldeneye, this is only the first of a trifecta of first-person shooter classics. Next up, we have got Doom 64, run on Watch Me Die difficulty, or just stupidly hard difficulty, however you want to call it, run by Peaches himself, the God Gamer. And then after that, we will have the world record holder himself for the legendary difficulty on Halo, Goat Rope.
All right, so see if we can go 2 for 2 on the flight recorder. That would be some phenomenal luck.
I think you spoke too soon, but we'll see. This is a marathon, after all.
Yeah, that's true. All right, let's try to affect the FR.
Yeah, that is one of the slowest ones there.
It actually spawned in one of the good 3 spots, but it's kind of random. Like, it doesn't instantly spawn. It just a few explosions that happened first, so it spawned late there, so I didn't get to see it when I first spawned.
And there you can see the guards holding Natalia hostage, which doesn't happen if you get back there fast enough.
And when the guards are there, you unfortunately cannot shoot Natalia before you exit the level.
Look at this insane pace.
So yeah, this is another really good time for donations here.
Sure. Let's go ahead and plug a couple of upcoming donation incentives. You guys have done a great job of meeting many of our donation incentives. We still have a few left. I'd like to point out a couple of the bidding wars. After our first-person shooter block here, it will be followed up by The Legend of Zelda Skyward Sword in prime time slot tonight. There's an 8-character limit to that. A couple of them that are in the lead is Blame TR, sitting at $704. And we have Mark at $405. You can donate for either one of those, or if you want to get in donations for any of the other choices or make up your own, go for it. All right. Oh, so I was about to point something out. It actually just got met. Another bidding war is early tomorrow morning. We will have a donation incentive of whether you want to watch a 1-player 2-controller run of Chippendale's Rescue Rangers 2 by Sinister One, or a co-op run where he'll let Fiesel get to play along as well. Right now, 1-player 2-controllers is actually ahead at about 1,700, co-op sitting at a little under 1,100.
I'm not sure, Alex, but look, you got there on the perfect line.
Didn't get the doubles, so it didn't matter.
And
yeah, if you haven't seen the Ryan Lockridge Streets 112 video, I definitely suggest YouTubing that.
It's pretty inspirational.
Well, it's put up a PG-13 on that one.
The music definitely fits the video.
I'm personally not a part of the Elite, but I'm friends with some of them, and shout-outs to them. They're one of the better gaming...
Super Metroid community in general. It's really awesome.
But they're one of the better speedrunning communities. They got a really nice leaderboard, and you can find them online and watch some great runs.
See, there he made it out. Well, there he made it out fast. But anyways, continue.
I'm going to go for the train shot this time. There's less guards and I have better health, so it's a little easier to set up. If that worked. Yeah, he warped the door on the train, but he still opened the roller door, so I won't have to open this door and it'll save 2 seconds there. It'll save like a second on this one if you get them both.
Yeah, ideally both doors would have been open there. But like you said, guards can just phase through doors sometimes. Because they're special like that.
Alright, I'm gonna get the body armor here just because of what happened on the dream hack race. If anyone saw that, yeah. Benia trolled the crap out of that race. I wanted his ammo, unfortunately, I didn't get it. Try to get this guy's ammo just in case. Where am I going? Wrong turn of that tree.
Xenia is significantly less threatening on Agent.
Yeah, if you get hit by a grenade there, she can, like, she has body armor and explosives don't deal damage to body armor, so she can stand there inside of an explosion and you just can't get close and you shoot. I'm gonna go for the elevator warp here. Saves like a half second if you get it. Nice.
Got it.
Alright, so unfortunately we have to play Control again. It is one of the longer levels. And we saw what happened last time, so hope for the best.
It is fortunately a bit more forgiving this time.
It is Secret Agent. I get more mines and the guards are less accurate, but they can still kill you. Really rough level. Normally we wouldn't get the body armor on Secret Agent, but in practice I've died a couple times, so I'm just gonna safe it. It's like a 6 second loss to get the body armor. And it's like a 5 minute loss if I die, so.
Would you like serious time for the run, or would you like me to read donations?
You can read donations.
You can keep going.
Just tell me when to shut up. You got it. I've got a $20 donation from Drax. You destroyed Bunker and you just kept quiet? That's it, Alex? No glib remarks? No pithy comebacks? Shoutouts to making Trevelyan kill himself with a grenade on Cradle. Also, in the words of Orimov, you can't win, from Drax. P.S. What happened to Franker Z? P.S. Franker Z, Franker Z, Franker Z? I've also got a $10 donation from Year Zero. Ha ha ha, time for Carmack. Hello to Druin, Ricky, Integer, Nekose, Sonic, Snowy, Dogma, and Lenny. Got a $35 donation from Stars Are Aligned. Just had to donate for my favorite runner to do Ninja Gaiden Pacifist. Loving the run so far, and thanks to all of you for the hours and hours of entertainment so far. Much love, Stars. Thank you very much, Stars. Got a
20.
I've got a $25 donation from Dramoth. Just got paid, so here's my donation.
How that's supposed to go.
We'll be driving to work for Spike's run, so donating now before I go to bed. Good luck to all the runners, and thanks for the amazing show.
Yeah, like you said, that is how that section is supposed to go. And with that, you can continue.
Yes, I've got a $5 donation from Irene's TV. Hey, Spike, really wish you could have done an FF9 speedrun this year. Really enjoyed it. Put this towards your choice, and can't wait to watch you dominate Rayman.
You can keep going with donations if there's any more.
Alright, let's see what we got here.
This'll go on for another couple minutes.
Yeah, unfortunately this is like a 2.5 minute segment that you just can't skip. We've tried everything with the TAS and it's like a scripted, even if you can't find a way to break it.
I've got a $40 I've got a $40 donation from at... You can't tell me what to do. It mixes me up. All right. $40 donation from at UUK. $20 to Metal Wolf Chaos All Cutscenes because he's the president, Jody. Now go turn some more guards into perforated cheese. That's the best request I've heard. Thank you. All right.
It's topical.
I've got a $10 donation from Minaki.
Still dying.
Hi guys, just wanted to wish Spike good luck on Rayman. My girlfriend's wanted me to wake her up at 4 a.m. just to watch it. You don't worry about it. True commitment if I ever saw it. Happy face. Good luck to all other runners as well, and more donations will be coming from me during this weekend. Well, thank you either way, Nanaki. I've got another $10 donation from DeFlow. Base Boost's Goldeneye run from AGDQ 2013 is what introduced me to these marathons. Really cool to see him work his magic live. It's taken me 50 minutes to write this comment because I can't stop watching. And I like where these are going. I've got a $40 donation from Michael B. Can't donate that much this year, but I gotta see Metal Wolf Chaos, what Metal Gear Chaos is about. Or Metal Wolf Chaos. I can't talk. I want to see what Metal Gear Chaos is. Let's check out. Also looking forward to the Halo run and the Doom race. Thank you for a wonderful event.
The guard spawned there at the end of the level in 00. Kind of luck-based, but if you, like, manipulate guard death, you can kind of prevent it from happening most of the time. It's unfortunate that I had almost no health when it went a lot smoother this time.
And I've got $10 more from Paramedic. Hey, Base Boost, great run so far. I will donate $10 more if Brown Man shows his beautiful mug on stream. All right, we got that. Sick.
So with this level of Trevelyan, it's like basically on a set timer. If you watch the cinemas there, it won't count for your in-game time, but the real time's the same either way. I just like to let him run to the end there to time the ending a bit better. I have to do a trick here where I'm on the same frame as both of them. Works. Did not work. I don't know if I can get the level with that anymore. Just hope to get a good luck here. I really hope he goes to the end. What is he doing? Please. Aw, oh, you're a jerk, Trev. I hit his shoulder, like, limb there, and I only got one bullet on it, so I didn't do enough damage to him. Bullet ended here, though. What the hell? Or reload, please? Oh, he's just gonna go to the end. That was unfortunate. It's, like, 7 seconds faster to do this than letting him kill himself, but unfortunately, this wasted 25 seconds, right? Missed the match.
Bye-bye.
See you later.
I like how kind you are about just letting him go by first.
Man, it's like after you. I'm just gonna shoot you when you start running.
No, trust me. I like this position.
All right, so this level is kind of serious time again. Hopefully I'll get the glass glitch. But it's really inconsistent. Even with a good setup. And then it'll be one level left after this.
That is it.
That's the big trick of the run. Glad I nailed that. But unfortunately, it's not over yet. I have to use a really risky strat in the final room. Saves like 30 seconds, though. I got a grenade. That's good. Guard here. He's a jerk, he's not coming up. No. I just hope we don't get knocked to the side by the guards.
Yeah, this is a strat that I was trying to say he would do earlier.
That's good.
Had he got the glass glitch that I didn't explain so coherently. Basically, he just runs over there.
Yeah,
and
so you don't have to kill Jaws with this strategy, and it's about 90 seconds. If you're doing full game runs, it's kind of discouraging when you lose runs to it, but just you have to go for it. It's too significant of a time gain.
Somebody asked earlier, but I believe Dam will be the last level.
Yeah, we're gonna finish on Dam because we don't have to watch the falling animation as part of the run. 6 second time saver. Pretty good.
Nice level.
So this is the last level in this category, and we do have a little bit of time for donations because most of this level is just running.
This is actually one of the least random levels in the game.
I've got a $35 donation from Xander Escalera. Hi guys, don't have much time this week to watch the stream, but I really had to donate. Keep up the good work. I've got $10 from Stars Are Aligned. Well, dang, I'll throw down another 10 towards 1P2CRR2. That's one player's two controllers, rest of your enders too, in case anyone was wondering. Also, Spike, you're another one of my favorites since you're reading. Happy face, Stars. Thank you very much. I don't know if I want to. Well, we'll read it. Sure, you put in money. $35 from Dennis Shear. Germany won against the USA today. This is great, but the cause you guys are playing for is even more great. Love what every one of you is doing. So keep up the good work. Greetings from Germany. Greetings. Thank you.
It's really weird there. Sometimes you just get more lag than normal, and your bullets just don't come out quickly. But if you have like a really good angle at the door, it reduces lag, and you get a quick alarm.
I've also got a $35 donation from Casey's On. Such a great cause. Keep it up. I'm locked in for Goldeneye and Doom 64. How is this the first time I've been to a GDQ? I don't know. Come back for more.
All right, so time's coming up right away. So as soon as you see the watch, we'll call time.
Well, as soon as you see the watch freeze, I should say.
This is just kind of a for show, but all right, time. All right, not bad. So, you may think I missed a cheat, but they didn't put the last one in the game. You can unlock it with Game Shark if you want, but that's everything there.
All right, another huge shout out to Base Boost for once again destroying GoldenEye 007 on stream. As I've stated many times, this is only the first in our block of three classic first-person shooters. Up next, we have got the one and only Peaches running Watch Me Die difficulty. Yes, that's actually what it's called, Watch Me Die difficulty in Doom 64. We'll be right back after this.
To him briefly. I think he's going to tell me.
Yeah, he's going to tell you.
Yeah.
Cool.